When feces or stool samples are sent to a lab, they are checked for different characteristics features such as color, consistency, presence of blood, mucus, gross parasite in it or not. These features are very important and will give you diagnostic clues for assumption or prediction of parasitism. The results of this gross examination of feces can be matched with different other clinical tests, which will help in final or confirmatory diagnosis. A submitted sample is first checked for normal color. Light gray feces indicates excessive fat in the feces, which further indicates inability of the animal to emulsify the fat due to problem in the liver, or animal have provided feed rich in excess fat. Dark red or black feces indicates the presence of blood in the feces. For an example, dark feces can be seen in hemoncosis, ancylostomiasis, etc. Whitish feces is seen in salmonellosis. Hairy color feces is observed in coccidiosis. Next, the fecal sample is checked for the consistency. Soft, watery feces indicates direct feces, and very hard feces is the indication of constipation. In many pathological conditions, as well as in different parasitic infection, blood in the feces can be found. For example, fresh blood can be found if there is injury in the rectum or coccidiosis caused by Imeria adenoides and Imeria galloparvovirus infection in Turkey. Presence of mucus in feces or stool as well indicates protozoal infections such as amebiasis, balanitidiasis, giardiasis. In whipworm infection in dog, excess mucus with blood is also observed. In different bacterial or viral infection, mucus can also be found. Gross parasites such as ascaris, larvae of roundworm in case of lungworm infection in different animals, larvae of stomach bot flies in case of gastroenterophilosis, troglodytes of cystores such as dipalidiasis, monigiasis can also be seen. Feces also check for odor, such as fetid diarrhea is seen in case of paramphistomiasis. So this is all about gross examination of fecal or stool sample. If you have any question, please put it in the comment section. I'll be happy to answer. Thanks for watching this video, and watch part 3 of this video lecture on the list of techniques or tests used in routine fecal or stool examination.